Hello viewers. Welcome to Seek Wisdom. First of all, we thank you for playing this video. Today in this video, we present you the summary of the book, The Power, written by Rhonda Byrne, the author of multi-seller book The Secret. Let's get started. You are meant to have an amazing life. You are meant to have everything you love and desire. Your work is meant to be exciting. Your relationships with your family and friends are meant to be filled with happiness. You are meant to have all the money you need to live a full, wonderful life. Life is so much easier than you think it is, and as you come to understand the way life works, and the power you have inside you, you will experience the magic of life in its fullness. And then you will have an amazing life. Your life is made up of only two kinds of things, positive things and negative things. Each area of your life, whether it's your health, money, relationships, work, or happiness, is either positive or negative to you. Most people who have a great life don't realize exactly what it was that they did to get it. But they did do something. They used the power that is the cause of everything good in life, and the power being referred here is love. This love is much more than loving your family, friends, and favorite things. Because love is not just a feeling. Love is the positive force of life. Without love, there is no life. Without love, you wouldn't move. There would be no positive force to propel you to get up in the morning, to work, play, dance, talk, learn, listen to music, or do anything at all. The law of attraction is the law of love, and it is the all-powerful law that keeps everything in harmony, from countless galaxies to atoms. What you give, you receive. Give positivity and you receive back a life full of positive things. Give negativity and you receive back a life filled with negative things. And how do you give positivity or negativity? Through your thoughts and your feelings. In any moment, you're giving either positive thoughts or negative thoughts and feelings. And whether they're positive or negative will determine what you receive back in your life. The law of attraction is unfailingly giving you every single thing in your life based on what you're giving out. You magnetize and receive the circumstances of wealth, health, relationships, your job, and every single event and experience in your life, based on the thoughts and feelings you're giving out. Your thoughts are both the words you hear in your head and the words you speak out loud. It's your thoughts that determine whether your words and actions will be positive or negative. But how do you know whether your thoughts are positive or negative? Your thoughts are positive when they are thoughts of what you want and love. And negative thoughts are thoughts of what you don't want and don't love. When you talk about any difficulties with money, a relationship, an illness, or even that the profits of your business are down, you are not talking about what you love. There are many little things that happen each day. If you get caught up in talking about what you don't love, every one of those little things brings more struggle and difficulty to your life. You have to talk about what you love, to bring what you love to you. How you feel in any one moment is more important than anything else, because how you feel right now is creating your life. Your thoughts and words have no power at all in your life without your feelings. Imagine your thoughts and words as being like a rocket ship, and your feelings as the fuel. Like everything else in life, your feelings can be either positive or negative, and all negative feelings come from a lack of love. The better you feel, like when you feel joyful, the more love you give out. And the more love you give, the more you receive. The reason you feel so bad with negative feelings is because love is the positive force of life, and negative feelings don't have much love in them. You can harness the power of a good feeling to the fullest by turning up its volume. To turn up the volume of a feeling, take charge of it and deliberately intensify it so you feel as good as you can. How you feel about each subject in your life, such as money, health, your job, and every individual relationship, is an exact reflection of what you have been giving out on each subject. For example, if you feel bad when you think about money, because you don't have enough, you must receive back negative circumstances and experiences of not having enough money. Because that is the negative feeling you're giving. Your good feelings tell you that when you feel good, life will be good. But you have to give good feelings first. Your feelings and thoughts have magnetic frequencies too. Good feelings mean you're on a positive frequency of love, and bad feelings means negative frequency. Whatever you feel, whether good or bad, determines your frequency, and like a magnet you attract the people, events, and circumstances that are on the same frequency. You can change your frequency at any time by changing how you feel, and everything around you will change. Don't put your feelings on automatic pilot, instead take charge of them. The life purpose for each of us is to overcome negativity by choosing love. The problem is that most people love and then stop loving hundreds of times in a day. They don't give love long enough for the force of love to move all the good things into their life. Throw out of your vocabulary words like terrible, horrible, disgusting, and awful, because when you say those words, they come with strong feelings. If you give more than 50% positive thoughts and feelings instead of negative, you have reached a tipping point. Once you reach the tipping point of giving more love than negativity, the love that comes back to you then multiplies itself by attracting more love through the law of attraction. To bring a specific desire to you, follow the simple steps of the creation process. There are three steps in this. 1. Imagine. Use your mind to focus on and imagine what you desire. 2. Feel. At the same time as you imagine, you must feel love for what you're imagining. 3. Receive. The force of love will work through the visible and invisible forces of nature to bring what you desire to you. While following this, keep in mind that imagining something that brings harm to another person comes not from love but from a lack of love. And with certainty, any negativity, even imagined, will turn back with an equal ferocity on the person who sent it. While using the creation process, use props. Surround yourself with items of clothing, pictures, photographs, and relevant objects, so you can imagine and feel the feelings of having what you want. Use all your senses to help you feel that you have what you want. Feel it, taste it, smell it, see it, and hear it. When you have completed your part in the creation process, you have moved into a new world that contains the very thing you want, even if you can't see it yet. Know you will receive it. Every person is surrounded by a magnetic field, and so wherever you go, the magnetic field goes with you. Every single time you give love, through your feelings, words, or actions, you add more love to the field around you. The more love you give, the greater and more powerful is your magnetic field. Whatever is in your magnetic field is attracting to itself, and so the more love in your field, the more power you have to attract the things you love. If you find your faith wavering, just put a dot in the center of a large circle, and next to the dot write the name of your desire. As often as you like, look at your drawing of the dot in the circle, knowing your desire is the size of that dot for the force of love. If you are using the creation process to change something negative, you don't need to think about what you want to change. All you have to do is give love for what you want, and the force of love will replace the negativity for you. Like if a person is injured and receiving medical help, but things are not improving, it means they're imagining and feeling the injury more than they're imagining and feeling a full recovery. Life is a catalog, and you are the one who chooses what you love from the catalog. But are you choosing the things you love, or are you too busy judging and labeling the bad things? For example, when you see your dream car go whizzing down the street, life is presenting that car to you. If you choose to feel nothing but love for that car, you are bringing your dream car to you. But if you feel envy or jealousy because someone else is driving your dream car, you just gonged yourself out of having your dream car. The law of attraction is the law of you. What you feel or think about another person, you do to you. Give judgment and criticism, and you give it to yourself. Give love and appreciation to another person or anything, and you give it to yourself. There is only yes for law of attraction. If you don't want anything, just turn away, but don't say no. Because when you say no to the things you don't love, you're feeling bad about them, you're giving bad feelings, and you will receive those feelings back as negative circumstances in your life. Your beliefs, true or untrue, form your world. What you imagine and feel to be true creates your life, because that is what you're giving to the law of attraction, and that is what will be returned to you. Give love as much as you can and feel as good as you can, and the force of love will surround you with people, circumstances, and events that you love. Fall in love with life. When you fall in love with life, you break the limitations on money, health, happiness, and the limits of joy and your relationships. Question comes, how do you fall in love with life? The same way you fall in love with another person. Whatever you're doing, wherever you are in your day, look for the things you love. You can look for technology and inventions you love. Look for buildings you love, cars and roads you love, cafes and restaurants you love, stores you love. To feel the love of everything around you, you have to be aware of everything that's around. People hypnotize themselves by listening to the thoughts in their head, and so they're in a kind of trance, and they're not aware of anything around them. The good news is that the more you give love, the more alert and aware you will become. Love brings complete alertness. One way to stay alert is to trick your mind by asking questions such as, what can I see that I love? How many things can I see that I love? What else is there that I love? When you ask your mind questions, it stops other thoughts immediately and it gets busy right away to give you the answers. Next comes the role of gratitude. Every time you feel grateful, you are giving love, and whatever you give, you receive. Whether you're giving thanks to a person or feeling grateful for a car, you are giving love for those things, and you will receive back more joy, more health, more money, more amazing experiences, more incredible relationships, more opportunities. Gratitude is a great multiplier. When you're grateful for the things you have, no matter how small they may be, you will receive more of those things. If you're in the midst of a difficult situation, look for something to be grateful for. When you find one thing, then look for another, because every single thing you find to be grateful for changes the situation. Gratitude is the bridge from negative feelings to harnessing the force of love. There is one certain way you can make yourself feel better about any subject in your life, and that is to create games with your imagination, and play. When you play and have fun, you feel really good, and really good circumstances come into your life. How do you play? You do the same thing as you did when you were a child, and you use your imagination to create make-believe games. Now comes the role of the power and money. The only difference between the wealthy people and everyone else is that the wealthy people give more good feelings about money than they do bad feelings. The reason why so many people feel bad about money is that they have negative beliefs about money. If you lack money in your life, it is because you are giving out more bad feelings than you are giving good feelings about money. When you don't feel good about money, you repel it. It will never stick to you. You have to give love and feel good about money to bring it to you and make it stick. How to change this is simple, like, don't react negatively to a big bill. You give bad feelings, and most surely you will receive bigger bills. When you pay your bills, find a way to make yourself feel good. Never pay your bills when you don't feel good. When you receive your salary, be grateful for it so it multiplies. You can use imagination to play games for money also. Anytime you hear of another person receiving more money or success, get excited. If you react with joy and excitement for the other person, you are saying yes to more money and success for yourself. If you react by feeling disappointed or envious that it's not happening to you, your bad feelings are saying no to more money and success for yourself. If you don't know what you want to do in your life, all you have to do is give love through good feelings, and you will magnetize everything you love to yourself. Similar is the role of feelings in success of a business. Next comes the role of the power in relationships. Relationships are your biggest channel to give love, and so you can change your entire life just through the love you give in your relationships. Give love to others through kindness, encouragement, support, gratitude, or any good feeling, and it comes back to you and multiplies itself, bringing love to every other area of your life, including your health, money, happiness, and career. Give negativity to others through criticism, anger, impatience, or any bad feeling, and you will receive that negativity back, guaranteed. One way to take the sting out of confrontational or difficult relationships is to imagine people as your own personal emotional trainers. If you imagine the people in your life as your personal emotional trainers, it will help you with any difficult relationships. The law of attraction is a sticky business. When you rejoice in another person's good fortune, their good fortune sticks to you. But when you think or discuss negative things about someone else, you're sticking those negative things to you too, and you're putting them into your own life. Similar is about gossiping. Gossip is not giving love. Gossip is giving negativity, and that's exactly what you receive back. Gossip is not harmful to the person who is being spoken of. It harms those gossiping. Life is presenting every person and circumstance to you so you can choose what you love and what you don't love. When you react to anything, you are reacting with your feelings. Your reaction, whether good or bad, sticks it to you, and in effect, you are saying you want more of it. A person surrounded by a magnetic field of anger doesn't feel good at all, and so if you come into their presence, they will most likely direct their anger at you. There's only one thing to do if this happens, and that is to find an excuse to politely walk away, so you can restore yourself with good feelings. The more you give love and feel good, the more magnetic your field becomes and the more it expands, drawing everything and everyone you love to you. Next comes role of the power in health. Being healthy is feeling the same way as little children feel, that is, bursting with energy every day. Their minds are clear. They're happy and free of worry and stress. Beliefs are simply repeated thoughts with strong feelings attached to them, like, I catch colds easily, I have a sensitive stomach. All these are beliefs, not facts. But whatever you believe and feel is true will be true for you. Whatever beliefs you give out, the law of attraction says you must receive back. To receive the health you want and love, you must give love. In the face of any sickness, give good feelings about health, because only love brings perfect health. Gratitude is the great multiplier, so say thank you for your health every single day. Every time you have a thought of something you don't like about your body, ignore that and say thank you with all your heart for what you do like about your body. Imagine and feel having the health you want in your body. Your body will change into whatever you want, but it can only do it through feelings of love and gratitude. It even applies to your beauty. The happier you are, the more beautiful you will be. Lines will fade, skin will tighten and begin to glow, hair will become thicker and stronger, eyes will begin to sparkle, and their color will intensify. The more you love, the more the force of love will melt away negativity in your body and in your mind. Life is magical. Life is responding to you. There are no accidents or coincidences. Every single thing has a frequency, and when anything comes into your life, it means it's on the same frequency as you are. You are being given messages and feedback constantly, and you have been receiving these messages all your life. Everything you see, every sign, color, person, object, everything you hear, every circumstance and event, are on your frequency. When you are feeling happy, then only happy people, circumstances, and events come into your life. Place the force of love ahead of you in everything you do. Imagine each thing in your day going well, and feel love inside yourself as much as you can, before you do anything. Ask questions every day. When you ask a question, you are giving a question, and you must receive the answer. Harness the force of love to help you with anything in your life. The force of love will be your personal assistant, money manager, personal health trainer, and relationship counselor. If your mind is consumed with too many details, the details will distract you and pull you down. Simplify your life, and don't give too much importance to the little things. The force of love has no opposite. There is no other power in life but love. All the negative things you see in the world are always a lack of love. To find heaven on earth is to live your life at the same frequency as your being. Pure love and joy. The greatest joy in life is giving, because unless you give, you will always be struggling to survive. Your love, your joy, your positivity, your excitement, your gratitude, and your passion are the true and everlasting things in life. All the riches in the world cannot even come close to the most priceless gift in all of creation, that is the love inside you. Give your love because it is the magnet to all the riches of life. While you are here, every time you choose the positive, every time you choose to feel good, you are giving your love, and with it you light up the world. Here we shall wind up the video. If you like this video, hit the like. Share it with your friends. We love to have your feedback on our efforts. If you have not yet subscribed this channel, do subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified about the latest updates.